Okay, serious. I've been serious. I was serious once. I'm actually serious. I was serious once. I said to my students there, my students were 12 at the time, now they're a bit older. I said, today I'm going to be serious because we have some serious grammar to teach, to learn. And my students all went, and one, there's always one, right, sitting over there, looked at me, looked at his watch. What are you doing? I'm timing you. I want to see how long you can be serious. All right. My name is Tracey Sinclair. I come from a country called Italy, for those of you that don't know me. Okay, do you know Italy?
Yes, somewhere in Africa.
It's the one that's very politically stable. My origins are... name a country that isn't. Well, actually, okay now. I come from a country originally from a country called New Zealand. Do you know New Zealand?
Yes.
Have you been there?
No.
Yes.
Some of you remember, not yet. You are not allowed in my classes to say no. It is absolutely prohibited. Okay. Now, I'm here because how many of you suffer from a thing called no money? How many of you see that word free? And that's not free, it's no money is good, and you're like, I'll have free, please. Yeah? Okay. Right, I'm a normal teacher like you. I buy things and I go fabulous. And when it says photocopyable, I'd love them even more. And when it doesn't say that, I can't say anything. Okay, basically, if you have your conference bags, you will see there is a catalogue that looks very similar to this, because it is this. Okay, this company is called Ali. I work for them sometimes, and they produce language games. Now, how many of you teach children who are little and they say, we've already done that? Yeah. And you think, And when you teach teenagers, they don't say it, they do the. Adults have another way of communicating. You remember us? So, we all have different ways. Right, how many of you teach the teeny tiny ones? Hello? Teeny tiny to me means under, say, 10, 11 years old. How many of you teach us that horrible age that has the words teen attached to it? Oh, I love you. How many of you teach the, oh, I know everything age, the ones that are 20 plus? Right, now I'm going to hopefully be able to do this. All right, I love this. How many of you, I'm sorry, this, when I saw this proverb, you know, you sort of relate to things. I saw this, so I remember thinking, that is me. How many of you have got up brother and up sister, or two brothers and two sisters? You know the moment when they play and you're the one stuck in the middle? Tracy, let's play tennis! You're the net. So, I had permanently this sort of... Okay, do you understand? Right, so what language games do we know? Doesn't matter because I'm going to ignore you. Same old, same old. The thing I was talking about, dunder. You know, what's up the new? The game or activity. Now, those of you who teach little kids, I do not use the word game. Preschoolers, yes. The primary school, sort of six upwards, I don't. Why don't I use the word game? Someone said it. When I say the word, we're going to have a game, I have about 5 minutes of absolute chaos in my class. I teach my children very quickly the word activity. We're going to have an activity. Also, because how many of you are mums or dads? What's the first question you ask your kid when they come home from school? Okay, and they come home and they say, games. You're like, I'm going to talk to your teacher. They come home and they say, activity. So we'll look at some ideas and hopefully some suggestions. Now, we all know about the pioneers. Montessori said, do you remember? We learn through playing. Okay. And Gardner has a philosophy about learning. He says that people learn in different ways. We have known these things for a very, very, very long time. Okay, we're teachers. We know that children go through different stages. We know that some children learn better on a Friday than they do on a Monday. We know that we learn better sometimes when we've had a lot of sleep. Do you know sleep? We said, ha ha ha, we're supposed to come and say, yeah, I'll do it often. Okay. We know about different approaches. We know about the lexical approach. We throw just words at our students. We know about the communicative approach, yeah? I detest the communicative approach sometimes. I have a class of 8-year-olds. How old are you? 8. How old are you? 8. Communication is fantastic. I have children who ask questions by going, Francesca, what's your name? So we understand the communicative approach is supposed to be, oh, I know the answer. The only person who is allowed to ask a question when they know the answer is you. Exactly. What is the difference between the present perfect and the past simple? Francesca? My students like this approach. You know this one? Those of you who are science teachers are giggling, the rest of you are going, what? Do you know osmosis? Scientifically, it is. You put an extremely wet thing next to an extremely dry thing. The moisture from one moves into the other, so you have 50-50. My students have the philosophy that standing next to me. Oh, sorry, does this mean something bad and boring? Start to the talk, I'll get thrown out. All right, so remember this. I've asked you about your students. Maturity. How many of you have got students that are extremely mature, able to work independently? Those of you who teach the teeny tiny tots, you know when you say go away and play a game and they come back and they go, is this right? Is this right? Is this wrong? He said this. Do you have that in your class? And they're about 15? Attitude to learning. How many of you have students who love school?
I do.
I actually teach my children. Hands up if you love school.
What?
I repeat the question, you say yes. Okay? How many of you love school?
Yes.
Yes! Okay, ask me the same question.
Do you love school?
I love school on Sundays. So I repeat the question, do you love school?
Yes, on Sundays.
Right. believe in this as well. The great aim of education is not knowledge, but action. So my philosophy is, today I'd like to play, so to speak, with you.
It's a bit rude to say that, really, isn't it?
We understand each other. We have jargon. You're not going to go outside and say, Tracey likes to play.
Right, vocabulary. We all teach vocabulary. It's part of Alexa's program. Ellie offers games such as verb bingo. Now, you'll find this quite difficult. It's a game which is bingo, okay? And the Lexus is... nothing gets past you at all. It's just amazing. Now, Tracey hasn't got it. She's got its friend. All right. Now, I bet you got it. Here it is. I'm a liar. I held it. Do you know the game?
Yes.
It's extremely difficult. You give the students a card, it has pictures, or it has the words. I'm just explaining this, because someone might say, I don't know what bingo is. There is one person who picks up the card and goes, cry. And the students go, no, I haven't got it. When they do have cry, they simply cover it with something, and the game continues. Now, it's very exciting once, very exciting twice. Read it the third time, they're already ready to strangle you. Now,
yeah.
What I love about the early games is that they have what they call the teacher's guide. Okay. Now, the teacher's guide has got all sorts of different activities that you can do. I have to embarrass myself because I have to hold it here. You're joking, I'm not. Now, how do we play this differently? We take a box. It all looks somewhere else. We're all embarrassed now. Now, because there are a bit more of you than I thought there was going to be, can I have some volunteers, please? Come on now! Now, I would suggest that those on the ends of the rows volunteer. And the ones in the middle are now going, yes! Right, I need more than one. Standing, aren't you standing lovely? Oh, I love you! What you do is form the children, the students, in groups, and then they're in a row. You then do a very classical thing called shuffling. And you pick the one that you think is good. Right, because you're a bastard, I'm going to give them a verb. Okay, now, what's the verb?
Get undressed.
Alright. Well, if you don't know your friend, now you know. I think you're wonderful. Actually, says mine. What's the paradigm? So, we'll give him some help, okay? Get undressed.
Got
undressed. And what's the third one?
Got.
Don't look so surprised. So, he gets 1 point, his team gets 1 point. Because they got the paradigm right with a bit of help. If you can get that card into that box, not like that, my darling, I'll give you a point.
Not to me.
Thank you for trying. I'll let you pick the card now.
Wake up.
Right, look at them.
Wake up.
You're Give me the paradigm.
Do I?
Yes.
Or they?
You.
Walk up. Walk in up.
Don't look at me, I look at my class, is that right? Yeah. Okay, now another point of getting in the box. What I like is, now you see, because I'm actually a really nice teacher.
Give me the paradigm. I give a present. Gave a present. Given a present.
Good girl! Thank you very much. And so on and so on. Okay. Thank you. Now, the verbs are divided obviously into two sets. You have irregular verbs and regular verbs. Now, the irregular verbs are easy because we all have the paradigms. What do you do with the regular verbs? Here comes an English pronunciation. Cry. What's the past?
Cried.
Shout.
Shouted.
Kiss.
Kissed.
Okay. What you have are the three different pronunciations for the past tense. So you get 1 point for pronouncing it absolutely perfectly, and 1 point for getting in the box. And yes, I do move the box. Because I have, we call them special needs students. I would have given him 1 point for just having get undressed as the first one. So you do need to move the box occasionally. We have a game called Who's Who. Do you know the game's Who's Who?
Yeah.
Who's Who is wonderful, has he got, has he not? And I'll come back to that later on because I want to talk about a game called Shopping List. Now, how many of you teach nutrition? How many of you teach food? How many of you teach children and you're like, what am I going to do with them now? I know how many there are.
Okay. Why don't we get out there?
Would you like to take one and throw them in the others?
I know you like to, but could you sort of... Now, I just thought if you see them physically, you'll know what I'm talking about. So if you can take one, not one each, obviously, but one with a group of students. So this is what I do in my classes. So I need a few
minutes while they pass them around. You guys are beginning, you haven't teach it. I'm supposed to take one and pass them on and keep them forever and ever. Special needs. One for you. One for your friends. One for you and your friends. Come on, we all got special needs in our students and our students in our classes. Just take one so you can see them as a group, if possible. Right, now. I was actually extremely horrible to a group of students. I have teenagers. I had a class, and I said, can you cook? Now, I discovered yesterday that maybe some of you are not so wonderfully enthusiastic about cooking. Now, I live in a country called Italy. Italians love food. They love cooking. And there is nothing worse than having a six-year-old tell you how to cook vegetables, and he's right.
Nana, that's what it's like.
Now, I give this to my students, not like the shopping list, but give them to the students like that, and I say, right, I'm coming for dinner tomorrow night. What are you going to make me? Those are your ingredients. So if you can see your card, if you can't, you'll have to sort of do what this lady is doing. What are you going to make for dinner?
Sauce.
There is absolutely no... Right, exactly. She has got asparagus, raspberries, lemons, rosemary, tomatoes, and mayonnaise. What is she going to make? If she turns it over, she's got the written word she can also make. Here, my students are creating. Now, I also teach students who are future workers in restaurants, future workers as chefs or cooks, for those of you doing ESP. I ask my students, not with those, this game is a bingo game, understandably, but as I said, we've just played bingo, I don't want to play bingo again. Each ingredient is on a separate card, so what you're looking at is on separate cards. I gave my students one of these cards, and in pairs, because obviously I don't have classes on this side, I don't have classes which are smaller. How big are your classes, please? Say something about 20. 20? 12, you're in heaven. 10. Can I come and work in Poland, please? I have 28, 27. At university, you have sometimes 40. The biggest class I've ever taught was 60, and now I'm beginning to wonder why I said that. Anyway, I gave my cards, my students, these cards, and I said to them, okay, children, I've got oranges. Can you see oranges if you come with the glasses on? Oranges. What can you tell me about the orange?
It's orange.
Oh, then nothing is passed through. It's orange. Okay, good. Round, okay?
Sour.
Juicy. Sweet. What are the origins of the orange? Where does it come from?
It's
a tree. Good. Thank you. Where does the tree grow?
Spain.
Spain. Okay, give me another country where it grows. Spain?
Greece.
Greece.
Cyprus,
Turkey.
Italy.
New Zealand. Italy. Okay. Does the orange grow in Sweden?
No.
Why not?
Not yet.
Yes. Never say never. I have been to Estonia. Do you know where Estonia is?
Yes.
Warm or cold comes to mind?
Cold.
They grow grapes to make into wine. Now I would have gone, ah! Except that the person was standing right next to me and I couldn't respond so enthusiastically. But I would have thought that grapes don't sort of grow where it's, you know, minus 30. On a good day. But what I found was interesting about this was we actually used the potato as an example. Now, does anyone know anything about the potato? It's round. Ha! Yellow on the inside, is it?
Yellowish,
whitish. Argue with your friend, don't argue with me, I know the answer. Where does the potato come from, kids? South America. Good girl. When did it arrive in Europe? The answer is a long time ago. It comes. Now, who can tell me which part of the potato plant do we eat? Right, so if you look at the card you're looking at, okay, those of you who can see, what I would do is the same thing. I've done the potato with you, I've done the orange with you. You choose one, you research it, and I want to know the origins. I want to know how I eat it, when I eat it. I want to know all of this. What does this mean? Who does the work? The students. Who has to do anything? I should say nothing. Me, which is the part I love most about teaching, because, as I said yesterday, I want a social life. Well, maybe you don't involve them. Restaurants close at 10 o'clock. Only here. The other places they close after 10. Like half past. I live in Italy. The restaurants close at 2 o'clock in the morning. If you want to go out for dinner at 1 o'clock, you go out for dinner at 1 o'clock. Here you go out for dinner at 1 o'clock and you starve to death. Okay? Fun?
Yes.
Lie and say yes. Come on.
Yes.
You're allowed to say no.
Lovely children. Would you like to give your very expensive cards to the end of the road?
They're extremely expensive. They're 39, I was about to say euro. All right, we're moving on. While the cards are moving down. Chopping it, just done that one, Tracy. Keep up with it. Oh, yes, that's what I didn't bring. Dictations. Do you do dictations?
Yes.
Do you like them?
Yes.
I know you do. Do students like them?
Yes.
For those of you who are old like me, dictations were in fashion back in the 1960s, the 1970s. It was really great. They even had the dictation method. Yeah, that was pretty scary. Before my time. She lies. Then they started saying dictation was disgusting, horrible, absolutely horrendous. So they removed it. Then very recently, as is with all, like music, you know, pop music goes out, everyone forgets it, and then all of a sudden it comes back, and your teenage kids come in and go, there's this really great song, and you listen to it, and it's something that you remember from 19 or something or other. Anyway. Question chain is absolutely wonderful. It is a game where the students hear a question. If they think they have the correct answer, they say the answer. But this is a wonderful game for you to create with your own students with their own problems. In Italy, with my little children, I have, how old are you? Fine, thank you. We have the problems of what does Mary like, what is Mary like. To my students, they hear like music. So this is a good game, which of course I then create my own questions with the philosophy of I'm listening to your problems. Tracy, move on. Okay. Oh, yes! Sorry. Oh, come on, you all look at books or look at something and go, yippee, don't you? It tends to be the book you're reading or something, not the book you have to actually use in class. Now, how many of you have been to a country called England? Scotland? Ireland? Northern Ireland? All four? None of them? Thank you. The United States of America. Whoa! Have never been to the United States of America and would have great difficulty saying or giving me more than 10 states. I just keep saying north and south and hope I'm right. Very often in course books, they concentrate on England or Scotland. Occasionally, they throw in Wales. Ireland is sort of chucked in there. Northern Ireland is like, oops, forgot that one. It's also part of the Great Britain. They throw in America after a while because, oh my goodness, we forgot to do that as well. And then that's it. Nowadays, you often get a little bit of Australia because, you know, it's that tiny, weeny country that's somewhere down the south. And then I come from a country where people go, oh, that's the one just over the bridge from Australia. I got told that I spoke quite good English.
I'm finished.
For someone who came from up there. Australia, as you all know, is called Down Under. New Zealand is called Way Down Under. That's what we're called. game, which is, I think, is absolutely wonderful. Be caught, that's why we...
Ooh!
You can see vaguely in my lovely photograph here, if you squint. You can see Big Ben, which is in... You can see a cup of tea, which is in...
Everywhere.
You can see, what do you call it?
Thank you.
States of Liberty. No, the Statue of Liberty, which is in
New York,
and originally came from
France.
Bloody, aren't they good here? Yeah. And you can see a thing that you throw keeps coming back at you.
Wow. You guys.
So you can actually see four countries represented there. Where does tea come from? According to the English, where does it come from? Right, it's called cha in England. Cha, meaning tea, chai. They think it comes from India. I hope there's no one English in the room. Who's stretching you out? Now, this game... We have lots of different countries. We have England, Wales, Ireland, Northern Ireland, Scotland, Australia, New Zealand,
Canada.
India, Canada.
Lots of African countries.
Running out of hands here. Lots of different countries. Now, they divide, basically what it is you have pictures of different things. I'm not going to throw them at you, I'm too kind. Baseball is an example here. Do you know about baseball? Mm-hmm. What is it?
It's a sport.
Where do they play it? Right, very common in the United States and
South
Africa. Right, in that part of the world. What do you know about baseball?
It's a sport. They play it in the United States of America. Would they play it with a ball? Not quite a round one, it's round. It's this tiny. They have a glove, right? Because it's so hard when you catch it. You got owl or other similar words. How many people play it at the same time?
A lot.
Good girl, I love you. Many, a lot is wonderful. I teach my students some. Okay, men or women?
Mostly men.
Male women's baseball. Okay. Do they play together, men and women?
No.
Who is now answering, thinking, please don't specifically look at me for the answer? We have the information here. So. Now, the concept behind this, I think, is absolutely wonderful. Basically, you have pictures representing, I should give you some examples. Yes, I should have put them on the slides, but seeing that my photographic ability is somewhat limited. You have food, places, monuments, symbols, people, animals and plants, traditions, and sport. What sport would you associate with New Zealand, for example?
Rugby.
What food would you associate with the UK? Fish and chips.
Beans.
I like that. Have you heard of hot cross buns?
Yes.
Pancakes?
Yes.
Have you heard of a thing called, let me see, scones?
Yes.
Do you like scones?
Yes.
I call them scones. Some people call them scones. I say scones. And I say that the city is called scones. Scones. Now, children. On the other card, which is blue, is anyone who's colourblind who has some serious problems? Okay, French. You have five clues to try and answer or give me one of the items on these cards. Yes, I am mean and nasty to you. It is a natural structure.
Mountain.
Thank you for taking part. It is millions of years old. Thank you for taking part. It is 348 metres high. Oh, I love you! Exactly, the two ladies in the middle. Exactly, here's Rob. Now, this I think is wonderful for geography because obviously geography, history, but we go outside the English-speaking world. Now, could you do that about famous places, people, food in your own country? Why not? And who does the work? Doesn't that sound good? So I love this game because it gave me the idea of, number one, introducing students to things outside their own domain. But the nice thing is, you've got beautiful pictures. Separate them into categories. Separate them into countries. T, you might put in England, which you might also put in China or India, because that's your relation, that's your problem, not mine. With my little kids, I didn't do the words. Forget that. What we did was things we know, things we don't know. What we do know, tell me about it. So who did the work? Are you going to wave at me? Mm-hmm. What time do I finish? Like now? What about now? Look at these lovely people. Oh, I love you. Oh, I've done that. Go away, Tracey. Your order is wonderful. Grammar. Do we like grammar?
Yes. Yes.
Who prefers grandpa? That's a serious question. We all like grammar.
Yes.
Do your kids like grammar?
No.
When you use the word grammar, do your kids start going, yay, and run to the toilet? The whole thing about grammar is that it's horrible in English. I don't know about Polish grammar, that's no idea. English grammar. It is more horrible. Horrible, oh, yes. No, because I think English grammar is like, at the beginning, really, really, really easy. It is, I promise you. The present simple we use in the present. And it's simple. You just add an S every so often to make your teacher happy, and everything's fine. And if you forget the future, you use the present simple. And if you forget the past, you use the present simple. What's the problem? Present progressive, also called continuous. That's another lovely form because it's present, and it's a bit longer than simple, so it must be aiming or something like that. Simple past, I mean, come on. It's quite simply in the past. Present perfect.
It's perfect.
It refers to the present. And it's absolutely perfect. Did your students hate the present perfect?
Yes.
I just think it's lovely internationally. It's every single place I've gone to, every single nationality I've spoken to. Why do the English have the present perfect? And I mean, what is the answer? I mean, give me the answer. I just say it's to confuse foreigners. Because it's horrible. I mean, it is absolutely horrible. It in Italian, it resembles what they call the recent past, but of course it's... And then prepositions. Prepositions are my favorite. They're those little... words. And every single nationality has its own little bits. My students have problems with throw at and throw to, because to them it's exactly the same word. And then, do you have the same problems with Polish? You must do. I know, it's horrible. I have the same problem with Italian. I make mistakes and everyone rolls around laughing and giggling and I'm standing there like an idiot, knowing I've said something wrong and just hoping it isn't something really bad. Which I have done in class with 13-year-olds. I wanted to say, today we will discover the future. A And instead I said, today we will basically be participating in horizontal tennis. I can tell you one thing, the students were all dead quiet. What are we doing today? Then I said to them very quickly, now you know why I speak to you in English at all times and not the future or any other form of the grammar. Right, now, somewhere here, oh, I don't, I do. This is why I love my organisation. Oh, there you are. Do you know the game Preposition Island? Okay, you'll never guess what it is.
Bingo.
It's basically a game which is a board game, and you have cards. I didn't bring every single game in, for goodness sake, I've got all life. It's got cards on with pirates. And the pirate says, oh, Bill is the boat. And the child looks a child. Adult. I do this with adults as well. Okay, I have no qualms about using a game like an activity like this with adults. I have a board. The board has got the pirates in various positions on the board.
Well, you try and find Bill.
Now, the nice thing is, of course, that the student picks up the game, picks up the cards, says, Bill is the boat. And, of course, you say, what are possibilities? Under the boat, on the boat, in the boat, near the boat, exactly. There's lots of possibilities. Well done. Find him on the piece of paper. Now, it's about this size, okay, and it's as busy as this one is. This is something different, and we'll come to this in just a moment. Now, I couldn't find Bill, I think he's called, to save my life. And, of course, I'm saying, well, who can help me? And no one could find Bill. He was so well hidden. This shows how much is going on in the picture. I very discreetly took my teacher's guide. Oh, come on, kids. You can find him. Now, this is what I love about being a teacher. Number one, I had the answer. Number two, I was something more than so I could find him. Now, for those of you who are old like me, I actually do wear glasses, but I have ceased to do so as frequently as I used to. Not because I'm embarrassed, absolutely no. It's because of the reaction of my students. The first time I put my glasses on, every single kid, the 27 in the class, all went, which is never a good sign when you're a teacher, I'm sorry. I look up, no, I won't do it, I'm too embarrassed. Put them on my nose, as one does. Who wears reading glasses? Please sympathise with me. And you have to put them here. You have to. So you put them here. I looked up and one of my kids... Now you look like a real professor. And I will never forget him saying that. Oh, shit. So now I've come to the lovely, this is what I love about being a teacher. You know when they come up and they go, is it right? And they do it like this. And when I was young, I would just go, yeah, it looks good to me. I can't bloody see what it is. So I just discreetly say, why don't you pop it down on the table and we'll have a look together. Come around. Love, I can see that. Oh, you guys can laugh. The whole thing is, when you've got a poster like this, this is absolutely perfect for grammar. The idea is the cards, and they have to locate various items. But I know you can't see it. Put your glasses on. But here's a little man. Okay, not so little. Where is he going? He's going to catch the bus. He's going to, or, in the past, where has he been? So all I need is something simple like this, and my students can start talking to each other, answering questions. What do I have to do? If they're younger, I have to do the questions. I understand that. When they're older, they can do it by themselves. And what did it cost me? 39. And I've got 6 buttons all in one. Sentence maker.
I'm not good at this, am I?
Don't run away, I'm nice. Sentence Maker is a new game from this year. It has, oh, you can actually see it. Can you see the circle-y thing? Mm-hmm. Circle-y thing.
Circle-y thing is that technical language.
Circle-y
thing.
Oh, you can't, you're just sitting behind. Basically, it is a series of verbs, and you can play it very simply as the game says, or you roll a die, the kids land on it and make a question. But what it does do is have time clauses. Now, I'd like you to be now. Come on, stand. What I want you to do is to stand in chronological order. And we're going to pick the people in the front, aren't we? Because they're easy.
Yes. Yes.
Don't you sit there hiding.
I've got that one hand already. Go for it. Yours is easy.
Oh, I didn't want to sit in the front row, then you shouldn't have. It's all right. I did a workshop with her before. I saw her growl at me. Go on, up you go. Put yourself in chronological order. In the game itself, these are on team time cards, okay? And there are about 30 of them. So if you've got big glasses, no problem. I've just chosen some. And I hope that you can read what this is, because if you can't, you've got problems. Sorry?
1 second.
No, they've got time clauses. All they have is time clauses.
Today's
conversation, though, isn't it? Right, are we ready? Are we happy? Right, so which is the one that is furthest ago?
Yonks
ago. What are you doing there? You should be over here, like years ago. Yonks ago. Hi. Then what have we got? Continue.
Yes.
Don't look at me, look at them. I don't speak English. Yes? Okay, good girl. Why? What's wrong? Do you have a special needs one? I love you. Now, this is why I chose them. Yesterday and this week.
Next month.
I think the film Back to the Future got us all. Are we happy now, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, so where are we now? We're now yesterday. Okay. Yesterday. This week. Are we happy with this week being after yesterday? No, I know the grammar, I'm asking you. When did this week start?
We
continue yesterday. This Monday.
You should be here.
See how much fun you can have with time? We could just keep going and they'll just be fighting for another 4 hours. Now, how often do you get your B1 students to do this?
Now is, let's say, on Thursday, so...
Yesterday.
What if you're talking about Thursday?
Then you must teach.
Yes,
dear.
Yes, dear.
Yes, dear.
Yes, dear.
Yes, dear.
Yes, dear.
Yes, dear.
Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. Yes, dear
Next month we agree. In a tick. Nine.
Okay.
In a
moment.
Today. Today's down to before now. This Monday.
Last Monday. It's future.
I would put her
in the
future. Okay. Now, I can see some of you going. This is one of those horrible words because, baby darling, no, very sheep. This Monday could very easily mean this Monday, meaning in 2 days' time.
Exactly.
But it depends on what day you're actually talking on. Today is some Saturday. It's nearly Sunday. Not where, isn't it? But if it was Wednesday, this Monday would be... Right, okay. So what I like is the part from the fact that... Have they had a little bit of fun? Are you happy with them now? Say yes, because we'll be here to
hear. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. You're lovely, lovely students.
Not today, darling. In a tick. In a
tick. I also love the expression in a tick. How many of you have got students or teenage sons who say to you, in a tick? Mama, promise I'll clean my room. The word tomorrow is one of those words which actually never comes to fruition. I've done those. Oh, yes. That's what I'm saying about grammar. Grammar is one of those wonderful things that using games, you saw what happened. It wasn't grammar because we didn't actually start the sentences, because we couldn't do present or past or future because they were still fighting about it. But we've got that idea. How good is your eyesight at the back of the room? Interesting. No, because we were talking about flashcards in the previous session I was in, and then also yesterday. Flashcards, I find are fascinating because have you ever made your own flashcards? And you hold them up, and you've got students at the back going, what? Have you ever tried them, like, with friends? Don't. Try them with people of the same age as your students. When you try them with your own friends are like the same age as you, they'll go like that, and then you get students with supersonic vision. Can you see this?
Yes.
Did you notice that these people are all saying yes? Can you see?
Yes.
With a little bit of difficulty. And if I did. Right, I haven't got time, but I will do this. I was going to do this. What I do is I give my students a piece of paper. I'm now going to give them to the man over there. I give them a card. And I tell them to, I ask my students, male or female?
Male.
Now, interestingly enough, the Australian government now gives you a form that says, male, female, undeclared. I I'm not quite sure if it's undeclared or sort of non-committing or something. But I thought, you know, the good old days where you just filled in a form and ticked female or male? This is a true story. Someone many years ago, an immigrant, arrived in New Zealand and it said sex. She actually did write yes, please. Over my head, but I remember my father laughing and laughing and laughing and saying to me what she had done, and I was like, true. She'd completely forgotten male or female. That would be more exciting, male or female. Right, tell me about the person who it is. What I do is I give my students a card, they have to tell me male or female. This one is very clearly female because she's got a swimsuit and a dress. Your choice. But it's also got a camera. It's also got a baseball cap. It's also got shorts. My students have to create a story about the person. The who's who game is very clear, he's got, she's got. My students are going up one step. Tell me what she looks like. Tell me what she likes. Tell me about her sport. What we then do is swap pieces of paper, and the other group writes sentences, writes questions. So for example, what type of music does she like? Probably not AC/DC, because she's got a very pretty frock. Okay, so here we have a bit more information. What languages does she speak? My students create the questions, not me. Obviously, if we've been doing things like character, there'll be more definition there. The nice thing is the students create, so we don't have to play bingo. And what do I have to do? Bless you. Nothing. Now, some of these are very clearly male or female, but some of them are not. This is the part I like. What do I have to do?
Get out a piece of paper. Find a partner. Not for life. Just.
Oh, come on, how many of you have had the class go? Now you have them? I give them all the time. You don't have to marry her, just work with her for a bit. Now here's one that I quite like. You've got the same swimsuit, but you've got a t-shirt. A very ambiguous young lady. This one is very definitely a girly girl. High heels, makeup. But the concept is, you tell me what she likes. Oh, that's fun. I mean. Now, I've done that. Yes, practice makes perfect. Get your students to practice more. I've been told I've got 3.5 seconds to go. Oh, yes! If you don't understand this, you're probably the same as me. Apart from what I've been telling you about, if you want more activities for each game, in each single game, Ettoi has supplied you with extra activities. The nice thing is you choose, whoa, look at that. I love modern technology. You simply do that. They've also given you a die inside it, just for different ways to play the same game to avoid.
I've already done that.
It's the truth. Values in games, which I also think are important. Taking turns. This is where I love the difference I was saying before. Little children.
It's your turn. It's my turn.
It's my turn. Then you get the teenagers. It's your turn. It's your turn. It's your turn. And then you get the adults with. The nice thing about the games is that you don't have to use I in the sense of I'm telling you the truth. You can lie. Because I always say to my students, I promise I will not call your mother, father, sister, brother, whoever it happens to be, and check up on you. Including my 76-year-old student. I promised I would not call his mother to check up on her. She was very happy with that. Oh yeah, I agree with this, yes?
Yes.
Okay, that's it. Thank you very much for coming.